And what about punch? Hi, Ryan Kendrick here from Dynamic Tape. We've been trying for a few years to explain the differences between different types of tapes to people. So today, with the help of old mate here, we're going to show you exactly what we mean. So we have our rigid athletic tape, which most people are familiar with. It doesn't have any stretch in any direction. It's used generally to try and lock things up, at least for a little while. Probably has some effects on the nervous system, although that's a little bit poorly understood at present. We then have our kinesiology tapes, and these do have some stretch in one direction. They don't stretch sideways, but they stretch longitudinally. You can see there they've got a little bit of recoil. They're designed mainly to go on towards the end of range, so with the muscle on stretch, have a similar elasticity and fitness to the skin so that it bunches things up and it lifts the skin, helps the circulation, take pressure off painful structures, and maybe you can change muscle activity via that input into the nervous system through the skin. Then we have our dynamic tape. And most people see that it stretches and they think it's similar to the kinesio tape, but in actual fact, it's probably more closely related to the rigid athletic tape. We're thinking about mechanics, we're thinking about using this like a bungee cord to resist motion, to decelerate motion, absorb load, and then to re-inject it back into the system. So it has a very strong recoil, something like 4 or 5 times what we find in the kinesiology tape, but then we can laminate it together to give us even stronger recoil again. It goes on in the opposite way, it goes on in a short position so that it resists motion and then springs it back to do some of the work that our muscles would normally have to do. We can use it to create strong compression to help stabilize things. So it's really a mechanical tape, a biomechanical tape, but at the opposite end of the spectrum of our rigid tape. So let's have a look at them in action and see what happens. Okay, so what happens when we put it on the body? Well, with no tape, the arm just hangs down. Do we get any punch out of it? Nothing, no muscles, no mechanical effect, just gravity hanging on, working on the arm. Okay, so now we've got the rigid athletic tape, let's see how that works. So, it holds the arm up against gravity, but what happens when we try and bend it? Can't go anywhere. And now if we try and see how much punch is in it, we can't go anywhere. We can get there, but what do we have to do? We can't move at the elbow, it's all going to come from the shoulder. Okay, what about our kinesiology tapes? Well, they're generally going on at the end of range to give us that lifting and bunching of the skin via the input into the nervous system, maybe changing our muscle activity and so on. If we lift it up though, we don't get a big mechanical effect. No nervous system, no effect. And as for punch, not much in the way of mechanical effect there either. Okay, but what if we try and get a maximal mechanical effect out of our kinesio? We can stick it on with the joint shortened up and, you know, say 50% or even more stretch on our tape, and then what happens? Well, we get a bit of a hold against gravity, but then we can't get through full range. We get hit that end point. And what about our punch? Pretty weak. Okay, well, what about dynamic tape? It's designed to be mechanical, designed to take load. Check out the resting position, it's already holding the arm up against gravity. If we bring it up, it stays there. But, importantly, we can still get through range. So not only is it holding it up and doing the work that your muscles, tendons, ligaments would have to do, but you can still function, we can still get through full range. And what about punch? So if you want a tape that seriously packs a punch, dynamic tape's the one you're after.